I went into rapping when I was 17. Well, I went to high school for only 2 years, and I dropped out in 10th grade, and then my dad told me to get a job. So when I was 17, I got a job at a restaurant called Randazzo's in Miami. A year after being a busboy, I just quit, and I was just like, fuck this. And then I just started making music because my friends, Denzel Curry, he's from Carroll City, I'm from Kendall, Miami. I was always around him and some of my friends, and like, I just said, you know what, I'm gonna try to make music.
What the fuck is good, LA? Hey, I came all the way from Miami to fuck with y'all. What's up? Everybody, y'all ready for this battle?
Denzel, motherfucking Curry.
What drew me into rapping? Like, I always liked it. In sixth grade, like, I went to the Boys and Girls Club and I battled this nigga named Preemie Sterling, and he was kept whooping my ass, but it kept on helping me get better. And then when I got into high school, I was like actually trying to record my shit on a $5 microphone from Walmart. Everything in Carroll City is like a whole bunch of like different sections. You got Myrtle Grove, you got ODH, you got Zone 3, Zone 4. Around my area, it was certain beefs like that with different individuals from one zone and another. It was crazy, nigga. Shit used to go down at the Popeyes. Kids used to get shot at the park. Like, I was around that element, and it was fueling me to, like, write about that
because
shit.
Because I ball out, road base, hoping I don't catch a case. Driving hard, swear to God, 45 on my waist. Ball out, rolling base, hoping I don't catch a case. Driving hard, swear to God, 45 on my waist.
I ain't saying niggas never get their buzz up. It's a fact that motherfuckers never loved us. Be the main talk in a barbershop chat, but I never let you see me get my bus cut.
Like, soon as I graduated high school, this was my life. It was fucking nuts, cause they already knew I was rapping at the table and shit, and people used to come by and like, oh shit, okay, Denzel rapping. Like, I look at the world, I look at my personal life first, and I look at everything that happened between like before nostalgic and after nostalgic, and see how things change. And then since there's a different change in the surroundings, it just makes me go in on that topic. You know what I mean? I just make my music for my soul. You know what I'm saying? I make it for me. I love like the type of shit I want to make. When I be listening to like my shit, I'm like, okay, I want to try to elevate this some way or somehow. And I think about what type of universe can I bring into this now? How can I make this crazier? How can I make this trippier? How can I switch up the flow? And that's what just plays in my head constantly.
These niggas wanna talk that shit. Always saying you a gangster, real niggas know. These niggas wanna talk that shit. Always saying you a gangster, real niggas know. Niggas wanna talk that shit. Always saying you a gangster.
I'm not gonna try to make no mishaps. I'm not even in this game to beef with nobody. I'm just here to make my music, make my money, make people happy. That's my thing. When you come to the show, I'm gonna be doing the same story and y'all gonna get lied to the shit. But when you actually sit down and listen to it in the headphones, like, this nigga's actually saying something. I wanna actually say something, but I want you to get live with it. And it's not even trapped to a certain degree. It's just like a whole bunch of stories to a whole. I wanna tell like the whole big stories, but it's gonna be in a way where I'm gonna tell it in the most trippiest, craziest sense and the craziest flow that's just gonna get you turned. Like, that's just very explosive and very, that just shows a lot of emotion and impact.
Slide for the free, kill for the feet. Pull out the stick, then I pull out the ski. Put a motherfucking face on a white tee. That's what a nigga get being P.I.E. Sweet, nigga, you D.I.E. Sleep, motherfucker, that's 6 feet. Deep, no tender, no love, no care. But a nigga here still gon' creep. TLC, put it to your Lisa Lopes. That's a nigga left eye, kill a nigga, get ghost. That's Patrick Swayze, come equipped with a vest. I'ma put that shit to your motherfucking neck. K's all in my trunk, so you better get a chopper. It's nothing but goon. I ain't talking Walker Flocker. That 275 goons 'bout to do a fucking gang. Bumpin' Walker Flocker plane.